Gentlemen, thank you both for coming this morning. I want to pick up first on the Katrina references, which generally go to the idea that once a president falls below that 50% line when it comes to honesty and trustworthiness, it makes it very hard to govern. Without relitigating George Bush and Katrina, Senator Barrasso, do you buy into that argument that the president may be in a hole he can't get out of?
He may be, Candy, and I'm a lot less concerned about the president and his legacy than I am about the lives of the people in my state in Wyoming and around the country who are being hurt by the policy of this health care law. They're losing their coverage, millions. They are being hit by sticker shock. They can't keep their doctors. And what the president has proposed is basically a false fix. It's a political Band-Aid. But it's not a permanent cure for the people that are being hurt by his policies. So it's time to start over with trying to get people the health care that they wanted from the beginning, which was affordable care from their doctor that they choose.
Congressman Clyburn, it remains true, however, that a president who loses kind of the faith of Americans finds it hard to pass other things, immigration, all the other things that are on what was a very ambitious second term agenda for this president. How does he win back trust? I'm assuming you think he can.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Thank you so much for having me this morning. I think that the president admitted that the buck stops with him. The fact of the matter is, this is a rollout problem. This is not a values problem. And I think that if we were to look at what we were attempting to do with the Affordable Health Care Act, you will know that what we're trying to do is change a value system in our country. Now, look, in all due respect to the senator, cancellation letters are not due or not new to my constituents. I've been hearing from constituents for the entire 21 years I've been in the Congress about cancellation letters that they've been getting from insurance companies. As soon as a child is born with diabetes, cannot get on your health care policy, get sick, go for your second treatment, you get a cancellation letter. You limit your benefits, you get annual benefits, a cancellation letter from your insurance company. So the fact of the matter is, we are trying to stop these cancellations, and now a few insurance companies have decided that to use the Affordable Care Act to send out a new set of cancellation letters. And what the president has done here is to say, okay, when you send out these letters, we want you to invite those people back in, take a year to let the people know exactly what it is that you've canceled. Can they keep, yes.
The question here, though, is, yes, they're, hopefully the website will get fixed, but isn't this the undermining of trust have to do with a huge management blunder? And the question then becomes to Americans looking at this website, which hasn't worked, looking at a promise that wasn't quite true, saying, wait a minute, if these people can't know ahead of time, they need to really test a website, can we trust them about implementing the rest of this? Isn't that the trust issue? And it's about management.
Well, sure, paradise lost, paradise regained. And when you lose something, you can find it again. And the president has admitted that he expects to be held responsible for regaining the Americans' trust. And I think he will. The fact of the matter is, one of our big problems in Washington is that we tend to react to sound bites a little bit too often, and therefore we tend to speak in sound bites. And this is a sound bite that the president probably needed to take some more time to explain to the American people, but you don't get reported. In fact, one of the things in Washington I dislike more than anything else is when people say to me, if you're explaining it, you're losing it. I don't like that at all. I really believe the American people are deserving of explanations, and right. We ought to take the time to explain it, and I think the media ought to report those explanations.
Let me bring in Senator Barrasso. So this... clearly, the president is off to a rough start on this. But one of the pushbacks whenever Republicans say this is wrong, that's wrong, is you never wanted it in the first place. So they sort of, you know, turn it back on you saying, yeah, it's been rough. Yeah, it's been terrible. But now you're just trying to undermine it. What is your take on the Republicans' next move to fix some of the things that you think are wrong with this?
Well, you know, Candy, this past week I introduced legislation, the State Health Care Choice Act, so states could make decisions if they wanted to opt out of the individual mandate or the employer mandate for the people in their states. I'm concerned about getting people health care that they need and want and can afford, and we don't have those happening with these policies. The website is just the tip of the iceberg, but for only every one person that's been able to sign up, 40 people have gotten cancellation letters. And you know, the president may call these junk policies or substandard policies, but they're policies that work for those people. I was with a rancher yesterday in Wyoming, in Laramie, others in Lusk who've gotten these letters, and it didn't meet the president's standards because it did, the insurance policy didn't include maternity coverage. But this is a woman that's had a hysterectomy. She shouldn't have to pay for that kind of coverage. Republican solutions are there. We need to level the playing field so that people who buy insurance individually at the same tax breaks as those who buy it and get it through work. We need to be able to let people to shop across state lines for better deals with insurance that works for them and their family, not something the government says they have to have. In terms of pre-existing conditions, my wife's a breast cancer survivor. She's been through 3 operations, chemotherapy twice. I know how critical it is to make sure that people with pre-existing conditions have affordable insurance, and states are able to do that. But what we're seeing is this failed website that's just the tip of the iceberg of lost coverage, losing your doctor, higher premiums, and the fraud that is coming, even on the healthcare.gov website, has been remarkable, and the fraudsters are out there in force trying to take advantage and steal identity of the American people.
Let me bring Congressman Clyburn back in. You had a vote last week in the House where 39 Democrats who voted for, many of them who voted for, if they were here, Obamacare, sided with Republicans on a fix to this idea of people being thrown off their health care when the president had promised they wouldn't be. What do you make of those 39 defections? Because politically speaking, it clearly is distance between the president and this bill.
Well, I think that what you saw in those 39 people, maybe 9 people had real serious concerns. The fact of the matter is about 30 of them, and I've talked to them, were insulating themselves against sound bites. And that's part of the problem.
Meaning that they looked back home, realized that people were upset, and they wanted to be able to say, I voted to fix this.
Meaning that people will look at this and say that this is a bill that allowed me to keep my insurance policy, and you voted against it. So they wanted to insulate themselves from that. But the fact of the matter is, if you look at the second part of that bill, it allowed insurance companies to continue selling what we know to be substandard
policies. Right, but they still voted
policies.
For it.
I mean, I call them junk.
Right.
Yes, they voted for it. Right. And as I said, I don't blame anybody for insulating themselves from these sound bites, because that's the world that we live in, unfortunately, but that's the world we live in.
And final word here, Senator Barrasso, do you see Republicans going forward, unless something amazing happens between now and next year, this is going to go into force, this law. Will Republicans work with the White House to fix things, or will you continue to want to change major portions of it?
It's time to start over. This health care law is terribly flawed. It is broken. It has failed the American people because they're losing their insurance. They're losing their doctor. Their premiums are going up. I think there's going to be a massive taxpayer bailout needed just to deal with the impact of this health care law. This is not what the American people wanted. The president did not need to destroy a good health care system to try to make a better one, but that's what we have now.
So that sort of sounds like a no on trying to fix it. Thanks so much, Senator John Barrasso, Congressman James Clyburn. I appreciate both your time today.